the serendipity that led to this concert. Many of you remember Beth Lemon. She's been here three times, and each time it's been really wonderful. Well, she made a recording of his friends with Mr. Magill here, and when he moved to North Carolina, she encouraged him to contact us, and it was a very timely event because I was groping for an idea for this concert. The rest of the season has already been set. And so we're really, really proud and glad to have Sam here, and it really adds a lot to our season. The music, the concerto by C.P.E. Bach, perhaps some of you know that C.P.E. Bach was the illustrious son of J.S. Bach. In fact, in his lifetime, he was more successful. Now, after his lifetime, he was a little bit less successful than J.S. Bach, but he really showed the old man how the business should be run. And we owe a big debt of gratitude to him because of the three sons that received the legacy from J.S. Bach, that is, his scores. He's the one that said, hey, I can make money off of this stuff, and preserved it, and published it, and publicized it. Now, his other son, Wilhelm Friedman, was a little bit sloppy rest of our musicians out. Somebody must get them. I think they might be expecting it too. Why don't you go get them and you won't have to suffer through my blabber. And so Sam came to us with a plan, and there's a couple of pieces we really wanted to do. And one of them was this concerto for three instruments by Vincent. And, you know, I know of several pieces by him, big orchestral pieces that are squarely in the repertoire. He's not one of the most standard of composers, except for us organists who really love the late 19th century Paris conservatory crowd. And Vincent Dandy was hanging around with all the great organ composers, say, Franck and Louis Pierre and Alexandre Dumont. And he was in this, he bridged 19th century into the 20th century, and along with a lot of the other French musicians of that era, was totally enamored by the music of Wagner, and they would make pilgrimages to Bayreuth to hear the Wagner operas. And obviously that affected his music, but his style is not, you know, he's in the same era perhaps as Debussy, but it's certainly not impressionistic music. It's kind of a hybrid, chromatic, 20th century, and this piece, the concerto, is very much like a Baroque concerto, grosso. You know, we have a small ensemble. Come on in. Well, we have a small ensemble, and it's a lot like a concerto grosso in the Baroque, where there would be a group of solo instruments playing against a string orchestra, which just doesn't happen. Now we have both Polina and Lucian joining us. We're very, very fortunate.